Hey guys, today we want to talk about conditioning and what that has to do with discipleship and disciple making. When we do our disciple making training, we play this game, and we didn't invent this game. It's a game that we got from somebody else. But the game is that we have three trash cans on one side of the room, and then we have about five or six bean bags, and we get three volunteers. And what we do is we just put the bean bags on the floor on the other side of the room, and we say, okay, who wants to play? And to the first volunteer, we say to them, just put the bean bags in the trash cans. And they say, well, that's it? And we say, yeah. And so they start throwing the bean bags from across the room, just like they were playing cornhole. Now, after they either got them in or missed, we go down and we turn over the trash cans. And on the bottom of the trash cans, there's numeric values written, 0, 10, or 100. And so we point out that, oh, the ones that got in the 100, they're worth 100 points. The ones in the 10 are worth 10, and 0 with 0. And so then we take the bean bags, we bring them back to the other side of the room, and we say to the second person, all right, are you ready? Well, put the bean bags in the trash can. Now, what do you think this person does? Obviously, they aim for the 100-point trash can, and they try to get all of the bean bags in that trash can to get the most points possible. And so at the end of that, we go over, we count their points, and then we go back over to the last person, and we say to them, put the bean bags in the trash can. And they normally throw it one or two times, and then we just repeat the instructions, put the bean bags in the trash can. And at this point in time, they start to have the wheels turning in their head, and they realize that all they need to do is walk over and put the bean bags in the trash can. Now, once everybody sits down, we basically pose this question, what just happened? What just happened? And people make some very obvious observations, like, well, with new information, you had a better way of playing the game. And they also, we say, well, how come people played it that way in the first place? And you realize that nobody can answer the question. We never said to play it that way. People assumed because that's where we put the beanbags, that's where you had to throw the beanbags from. And what we point out is that the reason people played it that way is because that's what they've observed. That they saw people playing cornhole, or they saw people playing games like that, you know, ring toss, and they just took the information that they had already observed as a person and they applied it to that situation. You see, the point of conditioning, that's what this is. This is conditioning. And the point of conditioning is that we tend to just do whatever we've observed. And so if the first time someone shows you how to use a saw, they're moving the board against the saw instead of moving the saw, you're going to think that's how you use a saw. And no one ever showed you the proper way to use it. You see, this is true in disciple making as well. It's true in not just disciple making, but in growing as a disciple. This is what I mean. The other day, I was talking with a couple who are doing the Lord's work, trying to make disciples in their city, and have great hearts to see this work done. And they were sharing with me how much they enjoy street evangelism, and they enjoy having conversations out on the street. They enjoy the power that can happen from handing out a tract, as well as from a verbal sharing of the gospel right on the spot with complete strangers. Guess how both of them came to faith? Both of them came to faith through that sort of means. And so, of course, that's near and dear to their heart. The truth is this, if you came to faith because someone invited you to church, what do you think your default behavior will be with people who you want to see come to faith? Inviting them to church. If you came to faith because someone gave you a Ravi Zacharias book or something like that, you're going to, by default, think, you know what? I'm going to give them this book. It was really powerful in my life. I bet it will be powerful in their life as well. Same thing is said with sharing tracts or sharing the gospel directly, or maybe sharing a podcast or a sermon. We tend to do to others what was done to us. See, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. All of those are valid ways to come to faith. But when we talk about making disciples in a way that is simple and healthy and reproducible, because that's what we talk about all the time, simple, healthy, reproducible disciples, disciple making, we realize that, well, what if you don't have the book? What if you don't have a tract? What if you don't have time to share the gospel? All these sorts of things, what can you do? And so what we try to impress upon people is that if you come to faith through simple conditioning, then you will use simple conditioning. As people who are already believers, if you can become reconditioned to use simple, healthy, reproducible tools, And then you use those simple, healthy, reproducible tools with people who do not yet know the Lord or brand new followers of Jesus, then they will use those same simple, healthy, reproducible tools with the people who they interact with. My father-in-law once told me a story when he was pastoring up in Syracuse that there was a man who was very bold about his faith, and he was always sharing his faith. And one time my father-in-law asked him, you know, why do you do what you do? Why are you like this? And he said to me, you know, early on, the person who led me to the Lord told me that I should start doing this, and no one ever told me it wasn't what Christians did. We wish more Christians did that sort of thing. So this is why having simple, healthy, reproducible tools, such as teaching people how to hear, obey, and share the Bible, teaching people how to share their testimony, teaching people how to share a scripture that they read that morning with a friend, family, or even a stranger, simple, reproducible, healthy tools and principles can go a long way in conditioning disciples to make healthy disciples who make healthy disciples who make healthy disciples. And so throughout these videos that we make, you're going to see examples of healthy conditioning. That's what we're all about. We want healthy conditioning, simple, reproducible conditioning, so that the gospel will go far and the gospel will go wide and the gospel will go deep within our nation and to the ends of the earth. And so think about what your practices are, the way that you grow as a disciple and the way that you make disciples or try to make disciples. That's evangelism as well as maturation and development. Are you modeling healthy conditioning? Are you modeling simple, reproducible conditioning, or is your conditioning complex and bloated? As an example of this, are you teaching your disciples how to hear, obey, and share the Word of God, just the Bible, or are you reliant on all kinds of external literature in order to do that? Now, devotionals are fine, but that's not simple, healthy, reproducible conditioning. And so think through that issue of conditioning. And maybe make a note in the comments or keep it to yourself in a journal of how God can help you grow in your own conditioning as you are a disciple, grow as a disciple, and make disciples. Tune in next time as we share more of these simple micro training to help you grow in these ways.